Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create this powerful superhero style emblem of a letter from scratch. This tutorial is in two parts. In the first part, I'll show you how to create this carbon fiber background and design the template for your emblem. In part two, I'll show you how to add color, texture, and dimension. The first step is to make your foreground and background colors white and black respectively. If they aren't, click this icon to make them black and white and invert them by clicking this icon. Create a new document by going to File and New. Name it whatever you'd like. Make its width 1550 pixels, its height 870 pixels, and the resolution 150 pixels per inch. The color mode is RGB and 8 bits per channel. Open your list of background contents and click Background Color. Then click OK. Make a copy of the background by pressing Ctrl-J on Windows or Command-J on a Mac. Go to View and make sure rulers and snap are checked. If they aren't, just click on them. Go to the ruler on the left and drag out a guideline to the center of your document. It'll snap in place because we have snap checked. If you don't see the guideline, press Ctrl or Command H. Go to the ruler at the top and drag down another guideline to the center. Open your gradient tool and make sure your radial gradient icon is active. Click the gradient box, which opens the gradient editor. Click the top left preset thumbnail, which represents your foreground and background colors. Click the lower left stop and the color box. In the brightness field, type in 50%. This gives us 50% gray. Then click OK on both windows. Go to the middle and press and hold Shift as you drag the gradient line to the right edge of your document, then release. Go to Filter and Filter Gallery. Open the Distort folder and click Glass. Make the texture Tiny Lens, the Distortion 20, the Smoothness 1, and the Scaling 50%. Then click OK. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Open your Pen tool and choose Path. If you're working on version CS5 or earlier, the Path tool is here. Click approximately here on your guideline and release. Click again approximately here. This draws a straight path. Release and press and hold Shift as you click again, approximately here, to add a 45-degree path. Holding Shift adheres the path to 45, 90, and 180 degrees. Release and press and hold Shift again as you click on the guideline to add a horizontal path. Release and press and hold Shift again as you click your first anchor point to close the path. Right-click directly on the path and click Make Selection. Keep the feather radius 0 pixels and click OK. We'll fill the selection with black, and since black is the background color, press Ctrl or Command plus Delete. To deselect it, press Ctrl or Command D. Make a copy of it. Go to Edit, Transform, and Flip Horizontal. Press V to open your Move tool, and press and hold Shift as you slide it across until it snaps to the vertical guideline. Merge the two shapes by pressing Ctrl or Command E. Hide the guidelines by pressing Ctrl or Command H. Double-click on an empty area of the shape layer to open its layer style window. Click Inner Glow. Change the blend mode to normal and the opacity 100%. Make the technique precise and the source edge. Make the choke 100% and the size 45 pixels. Click Stroke. Make the size 12 pixels and the position inside. Then click OK. Click off the eyeball next to the gradient background to hide the layer. We're ready to add text. Open your horizontal type tool and choose a heavy font. I'm using Kilogram Regular. If you'd like to use this font as well, I provided its link in the video's description or project files. Temporarily make its size 100 points, sharp, and center alignment. The color should be white. Click in the middle and type your character. For this font, I'm using uppercase. To enlarge it, click your Move tool and open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. Go to a corner, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it out. To reposition it, go inside the Transform and move it. You'll probably notice it's not moving smoothly. That's because Snap is still active. Go back to View and click Snap to deactivate it. Continue to reposition and resize it. Don't be concerned with the areas of your text that's outside the background shape. We'll take care of that next. To accept the transform, press Enter or Return. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask next to the text. Using the layer mask, we'll hide areas of the text that extend past the background shape. Open your Rectangular Marquee tool and drag a selection over the top of your character. We'll fill the selection with black, and since black is the foreground color, press Alt or Option plus Delete. Then deselect it. Open your Pencil tool and the Pencil Picker. Make its size approximately 70 pixels and its hardness and opacity 100%. Then press Enter or Return. If you don't see your pencil, you probably have the Shift key active. If you do, just press the Caps Lock key to see your pencil. Now draw over the bottom areas of your character that extend past the background shape. Click the large T to make your text active. Open the Channels panel. If you don't see it, go to Window and Channels. Click the small circular icon at the bottom to make a selection of the image on your canvas. Open back your Layers panel and click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. In this empty layer, fill the selection with black. Then deselect it. Make the gradient background visible and hide the text and the original background shape. In part 2, I'll show you how to transform it into a powerful superhero-style emblem. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.